In answer choice C, this is a modifying phrase. It's going to refer to the stuff that comes after the comma. So it sounds as if the defenses were famously known as hero or fort Sumter, which doesn't make sense. So answer choice C should be eliminated. Answer choice D is unnecessarily wordy and awkward in this construction. Who was also famously known as hero or fort Sumter? So choice D should be eliminated. Answer choice uses past continuous tense here, was commanding, when the entire sentence is in simple past tense. So answer choice E should be eliminated. And there is also a comma missing here. It's supposed to be extra information, famously known as something. And the main message is that Union General Robert Anderson was commanding something. So choice E should be eliminated. It's between A and B now. Answer choice B commits the mistake of having content which is crucial to the meaning of the sentence between two commas. Remember, extra information is kept between two commas. That this person was Union General is an important information, although that he was famously known as something may be extra information, but that he held a particular post is crucial information. So choice B should be eliminated. Let's confirm choice A now. So C answer choice A is a bit passive in construction, but remember, a passive construction is a demerit, it's not a deal breaker. So answer choice A reads commanding the defenses of Carleton Harbor at the start of the American Civil War was Union General Robert Anderson, famously known as hero of Fort Sumter. Although passive in construction, answer choice A is the best among the five answer choices.